In this scripting session, we will show you some of the advanced features of Autoloops. We will focus on creating custom Autoloops made for specific sections of a song, how to exclude these from the autoplay, and how to launch these using a MIDI controller. One way to describe the Autoloop features in SoundSwitch is that they are similar to lighting scenes in existing DMX software. However, during playback, they sync with the timing of your DJ software. Here, I'm going to create some custom Autoloops that are specifically designed for drops, breakdown, and intros. First, I'll rename the bank and call it Special Effects. Then I'll start by editing the first Autoloop. I want to create an Autoloop that has high energy, lots of strobes, and is specific to the drop in a song. I'll start by selecting the first three bars of the Autoloop, creating a strobe effect, and pushing the intensity to full. Then I'll go through and create some pulse effects on each bar and duplicate these by copy and pasting them throughout the rest of the Autoloop. To copy and paste, make a selection, press Command C or Control C to copy, and then Command V or Control V to paste. Because this Autoloop is 16 bars long, I want to have a second strobe sequence on the 9th bar, or when the next phrase of the song starts. When the drop of the song comes in, I want all the lights to point at the DJ booth. So I'll apply DJ booth positions at the start and end of each drop section, as well as add a few different position cues in between to keep things a little bit more interesting. At the end of the Autoloop, I'll add the change and hold position cue effect and choose one bar timing. Done. Now I'll move on and start creating an Autoloop specific for breakdowns in the song. Again, I'll select the first three bars and start by creating a fade out effect. I'll level out the intensity for the rest of the Autoloop. Make a selection and put in a few slow color changes. Remember, this is specific for a breakdown in a song. A section of a song where the energy decreases and the mood softens out a little. So some really nice simple color changes work well. At the end of the Autoloop, I want to bring that intensity back up so that on a 16 bar breakdown, the lights start to get brighter as it comes closer towards the drop or the verse of the song. Then I'll go through and add a few position cues to keep my moving heads moving around. Because these Autoloops are created specifically for different sections of the music, we want to make sure that these do not autoplay with the other Autoloops in the other banks. There's a little toggle button in the top right-hand corner of the bank which allows you to stop this bank of Autoloops from automatically playing with the rest. Now I'll go through and rename the rest of the Autoloops and copy and paste the same effects from the first two onto the rest. Here I only want to copy specific tracks from one Autoloop to the next. I'll start by selecting the intensity track, then holding Command or Control and clicking on the position track and paste that into another Autoloop. In this example, I want to copy everything except the color track. Now it's time to MIDI map. Right click to arm the button so it's waiting for a MIDI signal, and then press the button on the controller that you wish to launch that Autoloop with. Continue this until all the buttons in that bank are mapped. Let's jump over into performance mode and see how that looks. We'll be right back. these and more great tips, check out soundswitch.com.